Thank you for tuning in to another edition of the Vulcan Report. Right now you're looking at a daily chart of the silver futures contract, same for silver spot. As you can see, we closed still within the Kumo cloud here. Market's trying to decide if it wants to break and trade below the cloud. Looks like we have some downward pressure and momentum that will bring that to pass. We see another leg going down into below here, this support level of 3306. A close below that would set up the next bear leg down toward the $26 support level. As you can see, there's a wide drop between the 33 and the 26, a lot of space in between there, and really not a lot of support to go on. Once we trade below 33 and close below 33, it does open up the floodgates to 26. Now, I've been warning about that for some time. I have told my subscribers not to fall in love with any market. Now, with that said, I've never seen stronger fundamentals before on any market like I'm seeing on gold and silver. You know the economic ramifications behind this. Those have not been removed from the equation. Therefore, the fundamentals are still strong in support of an expensive silver and gold market. But just like any other market, there are bullish cycles and bearish cycles. As you can see, silver is still under distribution at this point. Market's still bullish. We are still managing to trade above trend line support. A close below the trend line support, this black line here, would set up an actual bear market phase. We could still get below here and not set up a bear phase just yet if it tries to find support and bounce from there. But we do run substantial risk of developing an actual bear market, meaning that the bull market would be over. So right now we are at a crossroads in silver. Are we going to see bearish market play out and start to move in an inverse relationship with the fundamentals? Or are we going to build support here and rally to new highs? That is yet to be seen. Right now we're still bullish. Take a look at what we have here. Today we closed down $1.73, or down 4.9%. as prices close lower than they open, with weak bids going into the close. Looking at our pulse scan swing VIX, we have a swing VIX reading now of 33.5, negative 33.5, which means we still have more downside to go before we're considered oversold on a swing VIX reading. The market pulse is negative since it's trading below its zero signal line, and the pulse scan crossed below the swing VIX, creating a downtrend channel as of today. This means that negative momentum has now entered the market, so we expect sideways to lower prices within the next 3 to 5 days. One note here is that, so we do have more downside that we can go before we consider ourselves oversold in any event, and this is starting as of today. You see this red bar. In addition to that, we're still within the Kumo cloud, so we could still go sideways for an indefinite period of time, or we could break below here. Right now, it's going to be hard-pressed to try to break out above the Kumo cloud, but we'll just see what happens. Silver has surprised us before. All right, one thing to note is that the swing VIX is below 29, or I should say, excuse me, it's trading below negative 29. This is where it usually forms a support, and the swing VIX usually forms support before the underlying security, so we're going to have to wait and see if prices bear this out. In addition to that, the silver price has set a new 14 period low, while the swing VIX is not, so this is a bullish divergence. And since the pulse scan leads the market 3 to 5 days out, we'll wait to see if an upside breakout occurs. Okay, since our last swing VIX signal, silver's price has been unchanged and has ranged from a high of 35.40 to a low of 33.48. Taking a look now at our momentum readings. Currently, the trend is neutral within the bullish Kumo consolidation cloud. So we're going to be on a lookout for possible trend reversals with downside bearish breakout risk, as we talked about previously. A close above 38.60 is needed to reestablish the upward trend. However, a close below 34.13 will establish a new downward trend, which is what we did today. We have no trend strength reading at this time. Taking a look at our intraday price projections, we have resistance at 34.96 and support at 33.91. We expect the 33.91 support to be violated and for the market to close below that tomorrow. Taking a look at our weekly pulse wave projections, we have our pulse wave breakout resistance at 39.56 and our pulse wave breakout support at 33.06. Finally, we have our volatility reading. Let's see, silver closed above the lower volatility band by 12.7%. This combined with the steep downward trend suggests that the downward trend in prices has a good chance of continuing. However, a short-term pullback inside of the bands is likely, and that's going to put us, you know, still trading sideways within the Kumo cloud. On a final note with the silver analysis, I just want to, you know, warn you. I've warned you before to be careful who you listen to. Price is all you really need to follow to know the truth and to know what's going on in the marketplace. You know, it's fun to prognosticate and talk about where we think prices are going to go between now and some other distant time in the future. It's all fun, but just remember, we can't trade off of that. We don't trade off of, you know, trying to predict anything. We trade off of price action. That is all you need to know. It is fun to speculate and talk about where you think things are going to go, but it's really neither here nor there. It's either you're profiting off of what the market is doing or you're not. It's just that simple. All this talk about the end of the world coming and all these dates and foolishness, people who actually try to make a living out off of that, you know, they're wrong like a million times and they never go away. They always keep coming back and moving the dates forward. So if they say May the 21st is doomsday and doomsday comes and nothing happens, then they'll say, okay, really, I was wrong. It's going to be June of next year or June the year after that or some other month way in the future. They're going to just keep you guessing into the future. And it's really an exercise in futility and ignorance. And really, a lot of time and discussion should not be labored upon in that area. Your time is better spent making money in the markets. There's always a bull market somewhere. There's always a bear market somewhere. And there are many opportunities to profit in the markets if you just follow the price and stop following the so-called gurus who think that they're, you know, that they know everything and they're so tight, but they don't have any of their own money at risk in the market, and they're not actually helping people to make money in the market. Not one of those gurus can come forward with a group of people to say, yeah, I follow this person and this person has made me financially independent because I follow their advice. Not one of them. None of them. Okay, if they were really that tight, they would be trading their own money, and or along with managing money for other people and making them wealthy as well. So they're just talking it. They're just blowing smoke. Everybody wants to be a guru, and it's very easy to be a guru in a bull market. But when you have market setups like this, what's happening to silver? Where are all the gurus now? All right, everyone's trying to be smart and say, hey, I told you to sell here at the top. They didn't say anything. And as a matter of fact, they missed out on all this bull run here. I know people personally who were short this whole time. They kept shorting and getting their faces ripped off. And then all of a sudden now, they're a genius because the market is corrected. No, I don't think so. Again, watch who you listen to. Don't spend a lot of time on YouTube listening to so-called gurus and CNBC. I mean, even they're running ads now, making fun of silver and saying how, you know, they're telling people to buy silver puts. Always do the opposite of what you hear the mainstream media saying, because that's where the real money is. All right, just FYI. Anyway, I got to cut this video short. I'm supposed to be on vacation, chilling here on the island, and instead I'm doing YouTube videos. Anyway, I'm done. I'm out. Remember, take what you can, give nothing back. Peace.